Good morning, Vishnu sir. Very happy to see you again. I really wish to meet you all in an offline mode very soon. I will give an introduction about myself itself. Whatever you said is something from my lab. So I want to say something out of box. So as mentioned, my name is Ritu SS. I am from Kerala. I'm basically an BTech agricultural engineer. I completed my graduation in 2019 and started preparation for, I did a hectic classroom preparation for 1 year and attended the examination in 2020. Fortunately, with the blessings of all my parents, teachers, and my friends, colleagues, I was able to clear it in the first attempt and I had secured all year rank 163. So I have to focus on 2-3 points at this point itself. I'm a person who came from a very humble rural background. My home is at a remote corner from the Thiruvananthapuram city. That is something as a border between Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Just 1 kilometer from my home, it's Tamil Nadu. So I'm from a border area. It's a hilly area. It's the first person in our region, someone who cracked the CSIS examination. I'm privileged for that. Why I said this? Because many of you might think that, you know, my background is not that much conducive to be a CSM. No matter, I am here. So then the second point is I had done my schooling, graduation, all in the government schools. I'm not a common product. I'm not a CBSE product. So if some of you have an apprehension that, no, it's something only for the people who have studied all their education, the English medium, and who are very prepared in English, like Kausha Chita, so then they only crack this. No worries, dears, because I'm here. So now we can start.
Yeah, my first question to you, what was the role that was played by Vishnuvardhan in your success?
Yeah, very, very great question. As a first question, I'm having the goosebumps right now. Vishnu sir, actually, I started preparation 2019. So at that time, this online education was not that much popular in our area. At least I was not aware of this. I had joined a coaching institute in the Thiruvananthapuram and I had done all my PCM studies, mains, tertiaries and all from Thiruvananthapuram only. At that time, I had joined a coaching institute for this anthropology. Anthropology is not a common optional subject in Kerala. So the availability of resource persons, the mentors are very difficult. Somehow I found a person. I'm not discrediting him. Yes, he is the first person who introduced me what is anthropology, but there were some issues. Even though, yeah, he studied me, he taught me. I'm grateful to him because he's also my teacher, but I was not confident in this subject because it took a quite long time because he used to postpone the classes. I don't know, because of his personal matters, I'm not blaming him. Yes, I do respect him, but I was not confident. So when the prelims got postponed, I was too much worried about the option. Yes, we know option is very much important because we have to write the 2 papers and that too, the game changes because all those papers, all the rest papers are written by everyone. So this option is very crucial. And it have the 500 marks. Oh my God, I can't even think of that 500 marks. Then confidence is the pillar in this examination. So I was very worried at that time. Fortunately, I came across a poster where the Vishnu sir classes of Vishnu sir was announced, a June batch. Then I just go through the YouTube and I have so many videos of him. I really become a fan of him. I still remember I saw a video about the absolute dating and relative dating. I really became a fan of it. So at that moment itself, I decided that yes, I'm going to do this online course. So I called the Vishnu sir, then the Vikram sir, and they were very friendly. And I inquired about the fees and all. They asked me, okay, you just pay as you can. Or you can just take some time. That's okay. They were always ready to support us because for them, more than the money, they were always willing to help us. So Vishnu sir, I can't express the gratitude to him. Actually, I'm getting emotional. That much mental connect I have with him. So I can't express with words the role played by Vishnu sir. If I think he was not there, I might not be able to score this much in optional, and I could sit before you like this. Even during the interview phase, I started working at some coaching institutions. So Vishnu sir used to call and said that don't be complacent on the preparation, prepare well. And he used to send the notes for anthropology. Like, he played a tremendous and remarkable role.
It's a great thing to hear. Listen to us. And one more question from you.
Okay.
What was the support given to you by your parents in your preparation days?
Yeah, they are the real heroes. They are the real persons who let me go and chase your dreams. Because my parents, okay, they also came from the humble background. And they also are not aware of this examination, the procedures and the pressure and all. But they understood all those things. My father used to say that, I can't help you in teaching. I can't help you in studying. Because I don't know what you are studying. But then just go ahead with that. Whatever things you feel right, just go with that. We'll be there for you. It's their mental support that brought me here.
Thank you, Ms. Ritu. Now I welcome once again our founder, director and faculty of anthropology, Vishnuvardhan sir. Welcome you. And I request Vishnu sir to take over.
Congratulations, Ritu. We are very happy.
Thank you, sir. Thank
you, sir. You're a fabulous success. That too in the very first attempt from government, college, government, everything is government. That's really very great. You are a role model for the underprivileged, for the backward, for the government school students, for the vernacular school students, college students. Really, Sridhu, it's a remarkable success.
Thank you.
By this, I will ask some questions from the students' point of view. Why? Because you should be an inspiration for everyone. So when did you decide and start the preparation of UPSC? What made you to prepare for civil services?
So it was my childhood dream. At that time, it was just because of the glamour and glory of the service. I used to see the collectors coming in the cars with the beacon light, the red light. And when I was in sixth standard, my school got the first civil servant. At that time, I still remember when he came out, the teachers go to him, they hugged him. I was like, what? He's an alien. So I thought that, yes, I also become a civil servant, and people used to come before me. But it was just some inspirational motivation for some small duration. And after my schooling, I joined a professional course. I did my BTEC Agricultural Engineering. And it was exactly during that time, I thought that I could do much better. For my graduation period, I got the opportunity to explore around India. I had done internship at different parts of India. And I got many opportunities to interact directly with the farmers who are at the ground level, who are at the grassroots level. There I saw the real rural agrarian crisis. Even after being an engineer and understanding many of the issues, I felt helpless. No, I am not able to do anything for them. Even though I am doing, it's just confined to some one or two families. But then this idea of civil services again reignited. And I thought that even if the agriculture engineering community lost one person, if I get into the service, I could do a tremendous job. And as I am also from the humble background, I could easily connect with those people. That empathy and compassion literally made me sleepless and brought me to this civil service field.
Great. Who is your inspiration, role model in this preparation process?
So I used to find inspiration in any person that I see around. Because everyone have a life, everyone have a story. That might not be a great thing for others, but I used to find the inspiration from everyone. So from Vishnu sir, I understood how a person from Telugu medium, a person from a very humble background came to this level and taught a number of people, made a number of officers. From my parents, how they brought me, made teachers, everyone. So I, rather than considering one person as a role model, I consider that everyone is unique, but we have to study from everyone in and around us. Then only we could improve ourselves.
Very rightly said. I will also be telling the same thing. We have to learn every day for civil services, from the society, from books, everywhere we have to learn something. From small children also we can learn anything. Yes, from honesty we can learn from the small children. Kids. Yes. Very great.
Kids, yes, sir. I have to say that from we grow up, we used to create them some fears like fear of failure, fear of mistake. That we can study from the children. We used to see how they fall and then they awake and then they walk. Yes. Like that, yes, the ups and downs are quite common. Just accept that, yes, ups and downs will happen. That's quite natural. And go with that. We could study from the kids more than any person.
Very good.
I still remember, sir, our baby's first day birthday celebration was conducted in our class.
Yes, correct. Yeah, my daughter's birthday celebration. Thank you, Sid, for reminding it. About time management, some of the students want to know how long one aspirant should prepare, how we should categorize the time.
Yes, sir. First, I have to say our fellow aspirants, my future colleagues, future bureaucrats, that no two toppers have the same strategy. So when you identify your strategy, when you prepare your own planning, then you are a successful aspirant. I might say that because I am a person who can study in the early morning, but after 7 p.m. I can't study because I used to feel very saturated. So I used to sleep at 8 p.m. or 9 p.m. I used to wake up at 1 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m. Depends. And there I have seen many people who have prepared this micro chart, like 6 a.m. I will wake up, 7 a.m. I will take bath, 8 p.m. I will have my food. But I am not a person like that. I understood that. I can't. That won't work for me. For me, it is a macro planning. I used to plan that, yes, within this week, I have to complete my polity, history, and I have to complete the first paper of anthropology. So I will just go with that rather than planning module 1.1 at 8 p.m., module 1.2 at 9 p.m. That, so identify what you can, what strategy will work for you. You have lived in this earth for more than 20 years for sure. So whatever you have acquired by this time, please, don't lose it at the end and decide that I will be a new person from today and I will prepare a new strategy for me. I am going to be an officer. Don't think like that. What you have acquired till this moment, use that. Make use of that in the best and beautiful way. Make use of your mentors. Just show them, sir, this will work. Is it working? And try it out. Just trial and error is the only possible way for you.
Very
for
great.
Me, I have done that as I was doing my PCM class. My timetable was also aligned with that. Rather than when the teacher study history, I don't try to go for geography. I also try to study history. And I definitely put some particular amount of time for optional, because optional is very crucial. So like that.
Very good. Yes, very great answer, Sritu.
Thank you, sir.
Most of the students are confused how to prepare current affairs, whether it is necessary to make daily notes for current affairs.
As I said, not to help us have the same strategy, but I will share my own. Yes. You have to read the newspaper daily. No compromise at all. Read, read, read. Only reading is the holy solution that we have, the magic solution we have. So I used to read. I used to read the e-paper, electronic paper. So at the 5 p.m., at 5 a.m., I used to read the newspaper. It's a part of my habit even today. So, editorial is very important. In the initial period, we might see that very casual. We are not understanding anything. Someone is going, someone is coming. That's okay. That's quite natural. Everyone will have such a phase. So, be realistic. Be accept that. Yes, something is happening somewhere, but at some point, we will understand that. So, what I did was, in the initial period, when I started preparing this Modi-ji Trump interactions all were happening, but I was not understanding what was India-US relation. Then only I could easily understand or critically analyze what is happening right now. So I used the YouTube videos, daily news analysis videos. I used the Baiju's videos because that was just for 30 minutes. And they used to upload it at 7 p.m. all the time. So from the 2019 June, I used to read the newspaper at the morning, and at the 7 p.m. I saw this YouTube video. That became a revision for me because I had read this, and at the evening, someone is explaining it to me along with the history. So it acted as a revision as well as filled the gap of my content. I didn't have the separate current affairs note. If I, when I was reading the newspaper, if I saw something very unique, oh, some edge point, I just copied and pasted in the Evernote application. I use the Evernote application because it is very easy to edit, as well as we can easily search and find out. Because at the end, we will have a bulky note. So it's very easy to use the controller rather than skimming through all the pages. So that was my kind of preparation. And I used the compilations for sure. But I used it in a smart way rather than literally going all the line. As I had read the newspaper, I know what is important and what is somewhat trivial facts. So I use their smart strategy as well as use of technology.
Very good. Very good. See, how many, another question from the students community, how many months or days we have to keep for prelims preparation?
So from the initial period itself, we are preparing for prelims and mains. We are internalizing the facts. When coming to the near days for prelims, we have to give much focus on the factual parts and the trivial facts. Because we can't remember where the Gabra was, who built this Qutub Minar. We will forget. That's quite natural. And don't worry about that. Yeah, I had studied in January, but I am not remembering it in February. That's quite natural. No one will remember. That's okay. So for prelims, I might say that in the last 2 or 3 months, we could give more focus on the prelims part, these factual parts. And we could somewhat sidestep the mains preparation. Not completely sidestep for the past 2 months. In the last 1 month, completely focus on the prelims. Because only when we clear the prelims, we could go for writing mains. And also, I want to point out that don't sideline the CSAT preparation. It is getting tougher each and every year. And I know many people who had scored very well in first paper were not able to clear the CSAT. And even though you being the engineer, don't feel that, yeah, I'm an engineer. I had done so many trigonometry. What is this? Normal CSAT, don't consider that, because in that pressure situation, we might not be able to do that. I wish everyone could do that. And don't think that I will do only English, I will do only maths. So give some ample time for CSAT as well. And the last 1 to 2 months, complete focus on prelims will let you easily clear this examination.
Whether prelims preparation and mains preparation both are different or it's an integrated approach?
So I feel that the whole UPSC preparation is an integrated one, because it is not just what you just read in that thing. It is something that what you internalize within you, then how you consider the society. So in the initial period, the foundation, we are strengthening the foundation. We are reading the NCERT. We are reading the standard textbooks. Those things are building our foundation. It is both important for the prelims and mains. I have seen my friends that they were thinking that first we have to clear the prelims, then only the mains will come. But after the prelims, we have just 3 months. Those 3 months are not for studying. That those things are just for revision. So be prepared that you have completed your optional before the prelims examination. You have done at least some kind of background work for the mains. And for the initial periods, I have seen my friends that they are studying these only factual parts. They are not looking into the analytical part. They are studying about the speaker, his articles, how he is appointed, how he is resigned, blah, blah, blah. But they are not looking into the what is the role of speaker, what is the issues with the positive speaker, how we can resolve this. This analytical part is coming in mains. But they are just focusing on the prelims part. Yeah, they will definitely clear the prelims. But they, what they will do after that? So I might advise my fellow aspirants, my future colleagues, that just go with that. In the initial period, have that curious mentality, have that analytical mentality. Try to find the holistic perspective of anything and everything happen around you. Not thinking that, yes, it is good for prelims and it is good for mains. You are a citizen. You are supposed to know all these things. In that attitude, cover as much as things possible. Think about that. Rather than just going for the coaching material, not alone. Yes, you can go for that. Alone. Think by yourself. When you are bathing, you can think now. When you are sleeping, when you are trying to sleep, you can think now. Just think for that. And ultimately, I might say that at some point, these things will come naturally. Rather than, yes, this is for mains, I have to write this. These things will come out naturally. That point, you are a successful candidate.
Sweetu, after having this conversation, why? Because we are every time in online only on mobile phone. You are listening the classes. We don't have this interaction, this much long yes. interaction. You are a deserved person. By talking to you, you are open-minded thing. You deserve it. You have enough knowledge. You are a material for IAS. Yes. A common problem. For every 3 to 4 days, the students will be demotivated. I believe that it happened to you also.
Definitely, sir. I'm not an exception.
So how you came across this? How you overcome this problem?
So first thing is that I accepted the fact this will happen. This will happen to everyone, whether it is the first time or whether it is someone who unfortunately didn't hear, this will happen. That acceptance itself made me confident. Yeah, that's not a solved problem of mine. That's not a weakness of mine. It's happening to everyone. Then one sir told me that if your body is not ready to study, don't compel it. So if I felt that, yeah, I'm having strong headache today, I won't compel my body to study. No, you have the time, you have to complete it in 10 hours today itself. I just go and take rest. And next day I can study well. So when I felt demotivated, I used to think why I came over here, why I skipped the campus placement, why I skipped the well-paid job, why I skipped the many family celebrations, my friends got settled, why I didn't go for that, why I didn't go to abroad. So what made me to come here? That itself reignited my demotivation. I strongly believed in myself. I strongly believe that if I don't believe in myself, who else will come and believe on me? So I believed in myself. So whenever I feel that, no, my marks are very low, I might not be able to clear this, at least this step, I thought that, why not? If all of us are doing, why not? I'm very brilliant, you know. I used to say myself, Shreedhar, you are brilliant. You are good enough. No worries, baby. Then if at some point, yeah, these things won't work. Even though I said, hey, Shreedhar, you are brilliant, I again said, no, I am not, I can't. Then I used to take the support of my mentors. I used to go with them. I used to say them, so I am not able to come across. I am not able to overcome this. When we go with them, we have some time of chit-chat with them. Definitely we can come out. Even at some point, those things are not working. You can definitely, if you are feeling some kind of depression, you can definitely take the help of a psychologist or psychiatrist. There is, we are the person who are supposed to break all these taboos about the mental health. Go with that. That's okay. It's our health. It's our life. We have to take the decisions. That's okay. Accept everything. This exam is tough, but it's not impossible. Yes, these ups and downs will come. That's okay. That's quite natural. At some point, we might not be able to study. That's okay. It is okay to be not okay all the time. That's okay. This open-minded. Consider this exam as a simple one, not a hectic, Herculean task. Consider this as a simple thing. Life is very simple and very beautiful.
Very great. Very great. What I believe the same, you also told the same. So before, when we quit, we have to think about why we started. Why we are here, as rightly said by Sreetu, I also the advocate of the same person. Problems or the issues, everyone, every human being, we have the problem, we have to come out of it. We have to be steady. The consistency is the only mantra for the success of this civil
service.
Sreetu, there are multiple sources are available. So how we have to confine our material, our resources?
Yes, sir, that's a very crucial point. Because now we are having the information flooding, overflooding, I might say. So I pursued that if I take one piece of paper to read, I make sure that I could read this paper twice or thrice. I have enough time to read it twice or thrice. So otherwise, I won't read. That is the smart strategy that I had used. For anthropology, my main source of material was a PPT shared by sir. Not even the textbook, because it was a little bulk. So that PPT, I don't know how many times I read that. I was literally, sometimes I might not be in a mood to read, but I just skimmed through that. That will refresh our memory. So amid this kind of information offloading, try to confine it. Read a paper for 25 times rather than reading 25 papers for one time. So that was my strategy. We just want to know very limited things for this examination. After all, for this 10-mark question, we will just have two pages to write. For 15-mark, we will just have 3 pages to write. You just need to know that content to write 3 pages, not in an academic sense. Understand the demand of this exam. They are not looking for a PhD scholar who knows anything and everything of the subject. You just need to know the immediate things, that the things everybody knows. always think that can I, may I know all the things that my fellow aspirants know, not in the very depth. My sir used to say that you can interact with any person who discuss the politics of America, but not about the politics of some of the particular junction of America. So that is the strategy. Have a peripheral as well as a little depth of knowledge, not the in-depth knowledge. We have enough time to go dwell into the in-depth when you get into the service.
Yes. So as only 12 to 13 days is left for prelims, you clear the prelims in the very first attempt. So this 13 days, how they have to prepare and how you prepared for your prelims. Why? Because clearing prelims is also a challenge. You cannot miss it.
Clearing now prelims. The competition is getting very tight.
Yes.
What I did was for the next two, I had started trying solving as many number of questions or question papers possible from the internet. We could download it from the free UPSC materials and all that website and all. I tried maximum number of question papers from different institutions because these question papers might be prepared by different guys. So I continued it for the next 2 weeks also. After that, I stopped that. So the final 1 month, the first 2 weeks also, I continued with the practicing the questions, model questions by different institutions. And I tried to go through the factual parts that we might forget at that point. So from this point, last 1 month, I was completely focusing on the prelims. I was focusing on the factual part of this examination. When I read the Lakshmikanth, I used to focus on what I said, the speaker, that kind of appointment removal, rather than looking into the analytical part. From the initial point, I tried to complete all the, the standard textbooks that I have. I kept essay the optional for last 1 month. Then maximum number of questions. I had already prepared the flowcharts and map kind of actions for final revisions. I used to read it many times. I used to go with that many times because then only that will get registered in our mind. For example, I had prepared a map of India myself. My drawing is not that much good, but I had prepared something like an Indian map. And in that, I used to mark all the folk dance in Kerala. What are the folk dance we have? In the Tamil Nadu, what are the folk dance? And that chart, that Indian map with the name of that dance itself will be in my table. I used to go with that. So when at the examination hall, then they write some dance form with Tamil Nadu. I know that it is not in Tamil Nadu. It is somewhere in North India, even though I am not pretty sure whether it was in UP, Bihar or somewhere. So in the last 1 month, I was always looking in the factual and real part. And I tried to go through all these materials all the time. And the current affairs was important. I had particularly debated some particular time. In the first 2 days, I will complete the current affairs of May. The next 2 days for June. Likewise, I completed in the first 2 weeks. And what I did in the first 2 weeks was again repeated in the next 2 weeks. So those things got revises for 20, 30 times by this 1 month. And I had given, even though I am an engineer, even though I am much comfortable in CSAT, I had definitely given some half an hour daily for the CSAT preparation. Just do it. Otherwise, we will forget. We have to add 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 in the examination hall. We might not be able to do that mental calculation. Because for the last 1 year, we might not be doing that. So this was my last 1 month strategy. And be cool, be calm. Don't compel your body too much because the exam is coming very near. And don't try to study the 24/7. Then on the examination day, you will have the black circles around your eyes and you will be having the headache over here. Have good food, have good water in the last 1 month. Don't be dehydrated. Keep yourself happy. Be happy. Don't be too much tense or stressed. Your efficiency will come down. Be happy. Give some time to your family or friends. Be self-disciplined. Don't go it more than half an hour. Just spend it some 10 or 15 minutes. That will again refresh you. Have proper refreshment as well.
It's 100% correct. So there is a disclaimer. The disclaimer is CSAT. Don't neglect CSAT.
Definitely.
I also know most of my students who scored 222 in the GS paper last 2020 when Sri2 attempted but didn't clear the prelims, CSAT, because of CSAT. So please don't neglect CSAT. Yes, there is one question from Eshwan. Why? Because you got 137 marks in essay. That is a very good score. So how you prepared for essay?
Actually, I didn't prepare for essay in a separate manner. I don't consider these exams in silos. Something in prelims, something in mains. So also in GS1, GS2, GS3. All these things are integrated. So as a person who studied for all this one, GS1, GS2, GS3, GS4 in the optionals and for the prelims, he had the ample content for essay. Only thing he has to do is that express it very well. Fortunately, I have some background in essay writing. So I was a little confident. I was comfortable because writing essay in this civil study exam is little different because here we are supposed to have this holistic perspective, this holistic angle, 360 degree. It should contain the political, social, economical, technological aspect. So I didn't prepare well for essay. So in the last minute, I had that tension of what will happen to my essay. So I might advise that, you know, those who start preparing, they could write at least one essay in every month. At least one. They could write more if they can. That will be very good. If they can't, I'll write at least one. I know the first initial essays won't be a good one. You might not have the guts to show it to others. The condition might be that much pathetic. That's okay. Those things will happen to everyone. Understand that. You might not be able to write 7 to 8, 10 pages. You might be able to write only 3 pages. That's okay. Understand that. Accept that. Identify your mistakes. Try to rectify it in the next essay. Slow and steadily, you will be able to clear this. And I am a person who used to read and I really like reading. So in the essay, I used to quote about the cinemas. I used to quote about the books that I read. That makes your essay something different. If I might say, there was a question about patriarchy in the essay. I wrote that essay. In that thing, I was expressing my emotions as a woman. How those kind of incidents make me sleepless. I just mentioned that there are issues with females even entering into the religious institutions. I expressed my wonder that in our India, we are considering women as goddess. But goddess is not giving the permission not to worship the way she wants. What an irony. I just expressed my emotions. I think it worked.
100%, 100% correct. So one is patriarchy essay, other essay is what?
Actually, I'm not exactly remembering what I wrote. I just want to look into the question paper and know.
Culture and civilization, anthropology essay came.
Yes, I decided to write that. Then I felt a little worried because if we choose an essay from the optional itself, we may go in the optional perspective. Like I might wrote about the E.B. Taylor, the L.S. Morgan, and go on, man. But I might miss some other perspectives and dimensions, as well as that become little complicated. The person who read might not know who is this E.B. Taylor or L.S. Morgan. They may think that, my God, what is happening here? So simplicity is the key. Try to be simple. Try to be a common man.
So I want to give one perspective from this. What Sreetu told, 100% correct. The decision making with respect to choosing of the essay is very important.
Definitely.
What she told is because of that reason only she got 137 directly, I can tell. The choosing, see, she properly choose the essay. Patriarchy, lot of general content we will have, lot of examples we can remember, lot of points, rational things, observations we can write it in the paper. That is the reason she got 137. It is approved, hence proved. Yes. How, thank you for your prelims strategy, for your essay strategy. How general studies for mains we should go on?
So for that, we have to write answers. Initial answers will be very pathetic and we might get wondered what I have wrote or what I will write. That's okay. The initial period will be very tough, but you have to write. Have the guts to write anything. Even if you don't know, write something. Coming to the mains answers, you have to be careful that you are addressing the question. You are answering to what is asked, not what you know. They are not asking what you know about speaker. They are asking about the issues of the position of speaker. Then you have to write what are the issues of position of speaker. Not about the resignation or the removal of speaker. Then the second thing is structure it properly. because there should be a flow. When I read a paper, I might feel that yes, it is smoothly flowing from the introduction to the conclusion. Not that it is getting disrupted all the time and you are just scattering the thoughts. I might feel that this person is not suitable for civil services because he's doing something impulsive. He's just writing what comes to his mind at that point. That's not the right strategy. Then the third thing is make it simple. Don't always turn for the edge points. Be sure that you have the general points as well. Don't miss the points that everyone will write. If you get something edge, that is a bonus for you. Then introduction and conclusion is also important. Don't think that only body is important. Once we saw an answer, we are first looking into the introduction. If we could give a good introduction, that is very beautiful because well begun is half done. And in the conclusion, always try to give an optimistic one. The civil servant is someone who is supposed to be a positive person, who is having some positive attitude in everything. So have a positive attitude. Then prepare. Have a holistic angle. Analyze everything in a social, political, economical, legal, technological, environmental, energetical, in that kind of dimension, rather than going in a unidimensional way. And if some question in economy comes, don't write only the perspective of businessman. Don't write only the perspective of the government. Try to identify different stakeholders and write in that direction. Then coming to the first paper, GS1 is somewhat more factual, I might say, because history is there. So you are supposed to know some basic things. We cannot recreate the Carnatic War right now. So you are supposed to know what the things happened in Carnatic War, but that too in the analytical manner. Try to interconnect all the aspects. For the geography, try to incorporate the graphs. The maps. Even for the history, you could use the maps because you could mark where that Panipat was, that location of Panipat. That will give an impression that, yes, this person knows something more than in the answer booklets. For the society, just look around you. Give that emotion. Give what you have seen. Include the examples that you have seen. You can include the examples of films, books that you have read. What you have seen, what happened in the last week. You can write that. Give a personal touch. Be unique. Don't go for similar to the toppers because we already have a topper in the service. We already have a person in IAS. We need a different person. Don't use your uniqueness. Identify your strengths and weakness. Work on your weakness to make it something better, at least to the average. But don't neglect your strength. Excel on that. The point when you excel in your strength and you try to rectify your weakness, you can present your best version, then you will be a successful candidate. Coming to the GS2, it is polity. Don't, Lakshmikant is not the end in polity. I might say that. You studied the Lakshmikant. Look around you. What is happening? What is happening in your state politics? What is happening in the union government? And analyze that and give that analytical perspective for polity. Social justice, as I said, yes, you are going to be a bureaucrat. Yes, you should have that social responsibility. Show that you have that responsibility. Show that you show your knowledge in the rules. How you know about the Vishaka guidelines? How you know about the POX Act? Show that you know everything. Just show that. Then GS3, economics. Try to add the statistics. But I would say that don't go for statistics alone. I have seen people reading very minute trivial facts. Trivial statistics. First thing, we cannot remember all these things in the examination hall at that pressure. Second thing is we are just having 7 to 10 minutes to write the answer. Don't make your answer sheet full of statistics. And seems like that, my God, it's something like budget. The reader, the person who evaluated will think that, my God, where should I start? It's full of numericals. Don't make that impression. Give that analytical perspective. Give that statistics. To the amount they want. Identify the weightage. It's not full of statistics. It is not just mere generic analytical. Have the proper weightage for factual, analytical, examples, statistics, flowcharts. And try to write in a neat manner. It is not about how good your handwriting is. Please don't make it so many cluttered, congested in a manner that when we take that paper, Oh my God, how can I read this? There is not even some space for getting some oxygen. Don't give that impression. You can write by writing. At some point, you will write some excellent answers. So then go with it. Then coming to GS for ethics, show your ethics are there. In the case study, consider that you are at that place, what you can do. Think in that manner. Be practical. Don't be too idealistic that when you are senior is corrupt, you're immediately going out there and putting him in the prison. That is not possible in our system. You don't have that authority to all the time go to the super senior of you and caught him and immediately take him to the court. Be practical. How you will do? You will analyze the facts, whether it is right or not, whether it is a spurious one. Then you will discuss with the colleagues what we can do. Discuss with the seniors what you can do. Look into the legal aspects. What are your powers? What the things that you can do? And then go with that rather than like we are seeing in the cinema, directly going and catching him by his collar. It's not possible. And for the ethics in the first portions also, try to look around you and write, express what you need to express. What is good governance? Up to you. What is happiness means to you? That's your personal answer. Don't think that the topper wrote that having the good conducive environment around you is happiness for you. For you, having chocolate might be the happiness. That's okay because you are unique. Understand that. Accept the fact and be who you are rather than just mocking.
Very great answer, Sridhu. Which is very practical, which is very true also. See, I personally believe this is not as part of the teacher of Sridhu. Personally, I'm telling as an outsider, the points which Sridhu is telling today is genuine, honest answers, 100% implemented, it will be useful for you. Yes. One more question, Sridhu. What is the new aspect which you explored in the process of preparation for civil services? What you discovered about yourself?
So when I decided that I will go for civil service preparation in the full term, I assured my parents that I'm not sure whether I could clear this exam because 99% of people who attend this exam will not be in the finalists. It's the fact. I accepted that reality. And I told them that I will be a better daughter for you. I will be a better sister for my brother. And I'll be a better citizen for this country. I gave that assurance and came forward. Even during my graduation and my schooling days, I was having a myopic view. I was just an engineer. My content knowledge was not that much poor in my graduation subject. Yes, I was an average, also above average student during the schooling and the colleges. I was having more awareness about the factual as well as the content part of my graduation, but I was totally unaware of what our constitution says, what are exact our rights and duties. What are the discriminations happening in and around us? Yes, I had faced something. I was just aware of that thing. And even we were debating within our home about the gender equality. I had many thoughts, but those things were really scattered. So I was not able to properly articulate that. But at this point, I'm pretty sure that Sridhu at 2019 and Sridhu at this moment is something different. And I became... due to the ignorance, we will have little more confidence. I was just seeing the people in and around in Kerala only. I was thinking, yes, this is the supreme one. But I came to understand that, yes, no, there is a world beyond this. There are people beyond this. There are crying poor around us. We have to look into them. We are supposed to extend our heart and hands to them. I became a better citizen, sir. This civil service preparation was an eye-opener. I used to when joke with my friends that everyone needs to do civil service preparation for at least 1 year. Then most of our problems in our society will end.
Yes, 100%. Yes. Who was your moral support in the times when you were demotivated, in failures? I know first attempt is success, in other failures. Who gave you moral support?
The failures is quite common because one thing I did was I did all my failures in the test series. I made sure that it won't happen in the right examination hall and I did all the mistakes that I could have in the test series itself. So, yes, so I am not a person who had not experienced the failures. the mental support was first thing is everyone supported me. Everyone believed in me. I used to get away from the person who are pessimistic or who are always jealous. Oh, you won't be able to clear this. What? These are something for some other people, so for aliens only. Those are nothing for some common man like us. I used to get away from them. That itself gave me some mental support. Then second thing is my parents. I used to share with them, no, I'm not able to getting it right. I shared with my mentors. Mentors used to connect it well because they also faced all these issues. And they used to tell me that, no, Sridhu, this happens to everyone. No issues. You can do that. You have the caliber. Those kind words. I still want to express the gratitude to all my mentors because their support. It was the key because for Vishnusa, I am seeing him as my God because some to a higher position, very higher position, very superior position because he have an experience of these many years with respect to age, with respect to job, with respect to the interactions with the people. So when he say that, no, Sridhu, you can do that, this. You have the caliber. I used to feel that, yes, if sir feels so, then there is some point in that. No, I can also do that. I used to find I was always open to criticism. And I was always ready to seek help from others. So that itself kept me take care of my mental health aspects.
100% that, yes. So in this context, you have been talking about test series. How the test series will be helpful for the aspirants?
Test series will help us to give the real experience of an examination. Because whether it is for prelims or mains, we are writing it in a very pressured situation, very stressful situation. And time management is very important. We have to write a lot. So this test series, from the initial test series, we might not be able to complete all the 20 questions. We might end up in 10 or 20 questions. That's okay. Slow and steadily, we could study that time management that an outside person cannot teach us. That comes only through the practice. So when we write the test series and all, we could manage the time, and at the examination hall, we could complete all the questions because it is very important to complete all the questions. Second thing is test is not the end. I used to say that. We can take this comment in two ways. First thing is, if you lose some marks in the test series or in a test, don't worry. It's just a test now. You have many more tests to come. The ultimate, the D-Day is yet to come. So don't worry about that. And have the confidence to write the test even you have studied nothing. Because at the end, in the examination hall, we will get many questions where we don't know anything. We have to write back. But we are supposed to write the answer. So attempt the test series, whatever you have. Don't think that I will write the series only after completing all the studies. That is not going to be possible in 5, 6, or 7 years. Second thing is, after writing the test, if you got 110 mark for 250, great, great marks. But don't just keep it over there. Yeah, I got 110 marks now. I am a genius person. Don't think like that. Go to your mentors and ask them, what are my faults? How I can improve? There is scope of improvement all the time. Only when you improve your mistakes, you are improving. You are getting succeeding. Otherwise, there is no point writing 100 answers. Write one answer. Go to a mentor. Ask him how you can correct it. For the next answer, rectify the problem. Slowly and steadily. There might be a minor change, but it matters. Slowly and steadily, your answers is going to be a wonderful one and you are going to score and remarkable marks. So test series is very important and self-introspection is important. Always, always remember that not just randomly or mindlessly write hundreds of answers. Smartly do work. Work on your answers.
Very great answers. 100% true. Writing practice is very, very important. Without writing practice, nowhere you are going to stand. Sona asked one question. Everyone want to know about your interview experience. Why? Because you got very good marks, 184. 184 is a very good score. But by speaking, we had a very good conversation by which I can come to a conclusion that 184 is less marks. You are desirable. You can get what, 210 marks. So please, can you share your interview experience?
With my fellow aspirants, I have to say one thing. Even I started preparation, whenever I saw a successful or the prone candidate, I used to ask them about the interview experience. But my dear friends always make sure that you definitely ask them about their prelims and main strategies, because interviews are final process. the prelims and mains is also important. Coming to the interview experience, I got the board of Dr. Manoj Soni. I was not this much confident at that point. Yes, I was confident, but I could have done much something better. Yeah, that day was very crucial. It was like the D-Day for me, for my life. I had stayed at the Kerala house, and at that morning, I still remember, I was literally shivering. I was very little tense, but I was saying myself, Sridhu, you have prepared well, no worry, dear. And I went over there. We have to do a number of paperworks over there. After that paperwork, I was the fourth person to go, and I had waited for them. And some person came and he took me to the hall where the interview is conducted. And I sat over there. That 5 minutes is very crucial, very, very crucial, because we won't be able to sit there properly the whole life. I am 24 years old. Whole episodes of these 24 years came before me. I was like, I was very young, my teachers, my parents. That 5 minutes is very crucial. Yes, I tried to do some breathing exercise over there, and I kept very calm. I always try to have the smile for all the questions. Whether it was very tough, whether I don't know anything, but I tried to have this positive aura around me. I tried to maintain this smile. I entered the hall. I heard that for my friends and all, chairperson used to make them very calm, be happy, be comfortable. It's not a policing location, but my experience was something different. Whenever I came over and sit there, they immediately started questioning me. There were no comforting, there were no pampering. The Manoj Soni sir immediately asked, name Sridhu, is it a Malayalam word? What it mean? You might feel that it is a trivial question, but it's an important question. You have to know who you are. So from that point, we started there were two lady members and three gents. As I am a person from agricultural background, they asked me different questions about agrarian distress, how we can solve it, does it really exist? But one person asked me about agriculture in China. What is the status at this point? I immediately said that, sir, I am aware of India, but I might not be competent enough to comment on agriculture in China. Yes, he accepted that. Then as I was from Kerala, I got the questions from Padmanabha Swami Temple, the Shabarimala Temple. In the Shabarimala question, they literally tried to corner me. They asked me, is it really important for a woman to get into the temple? There are many more priorities for them. Likewise, but I think, yes, I was able to give them good answers. But the next person asked me about the palm oil scandal in Kerala. That was something happened in 1990s. Before I was born, I was like, yes, I heard of that, but I don't know, because it happened something much before I was born, and the follow-ups happened when I was in KG section, LKG, UKG. I have not even studied to read at that point. I literally expressed that. I said that, sir, I heard of this, but I'm not aware of the exact nuances of that. Then he was willing to explain me all the things, what actually happened in that palm oil case. And he asked some my opinion, what you might have done at that point. It was also a healthy discussion. Then other person, we had a very good discussion about the women empowerment aspect, because I was also very interested in that topic. And then madam asked me, when I was strongly advocating for this women empowerment, she asked me that, it is distorting our social structure. What are you saying in that manner? So I said that, ma'am, women empowerment is not about women dominating men. It is about gender equality. Whether it is men, women, or transgender, they have the equal rights and opportunities. It is not about anyone dominating other persons. I feel that, yes, that answer was an impressive one for everyone, because there was a smile in everyone's face. Other thing was that the chairman, Manusa, asked that, are you a good leader? I feel that he was expecting a very long answer from me, and just he sit like this. Then I just said that, yes, sir, I believe so. Then everyone started laughing. Then Manasa said that, yes, you have to believe in yourself. Yes, that belief is going to take you to the heights, and in that manner. But actually, after the interview, I was not satisfied because I had prepared a lot for this interview, but they didn't ask me anything. Nothing about Afghanistan, nothing about Pegasus, nothing. Even though I prepared a lot, and I was not having that much a good impression because they used to try me to corner. They tried me to intimidate many times. But as the results are out, I feel that no, that was worth.
How much time it went?
For interview, sir?
Yes.
So I believe that it is, as it is a personality test, be unique, be who you are. Rather than just seeing all the things and looking into the top of stuff, the way they sit, the way they communicate. Yes, that mannerisms are important, but who you are. So I read my newspapers, 2-3 newspapers daily. I attended mock tests, but I made sure that I'm not going behind the mock test all the time. Rather than that, after the mock test, I collected the videos. I showed it to my mentors and asked them, how can I improve? And they told that you could improve on your facial expressions, the hand gestures. In that manner, rather than going for number of mocks, I believed in self-introspection. How the mistakes can be rectified then. During this preparation, interview preparation, I felt much more relaxed rather than this main center interview. So I used to read a number of books in this period. That also added my personality.
That was good. It's 35 minutes or 40 minutes every interview?
35 minutes, sir.
So we will open up a few questions from the students. Sona, okay. Are you interested to ask the question directly?
Dear friends, I have to say one thing. Don't call me madam. It is a colonial legacy. You can call me my name, Sridhu. And consider me as someone within you because just few days back, I was also like you. And still, I am like you. So be comfortable. Shoot your questions to me.
Hello, good morning, ma'am. Am I audible?
I just said that. Don't call me madam. You can call me Sridhu.
Sorry.
You have some issues like then age difference or something? In your language, you can use the word for sister. In Malayalam, it is Chechi.
Sweet Chechi, can I talk in Malayalam?
But we are unable to understand.
Okay.
Okay, if you have some issues with English, then you can definitely speak in Malayalam. I will translate.
No. Okay, I will speak in English. Any anthropological questions that we asked in your interview?
They just asked me what is culture. I had quoted E.B. Taylor and gave his definition. And then the discussion went on to the constitution, the constitutional provisions of culture. That person was from law background, I think, because the many questions were in law related aspects. So that went on there.
Nancy, Anthony, do you want to ask?
Thank you, Sridhar. Yes.
Yes, Benz. Unmute.
No, I was just keenly listening to what Sridhar Chichi is telling because really wonderful. And she was Sridhar Chichi was a friend of my friend's friend. My friend Ardra, her friend is Sridhar Chichi. She told a lot about her. So I was just keenly watching Sridhar Chichi throughout this talk.
Oh my God. Thank you, dear.
Actually, I heard about you. Once you cleared this examination, she put your picture as a status. And I asked her, who is she? And he told me that it's Sridhar Chichi, her immediate friend. And it was just, I heard about you. And it's now I'm seeing you face to face, and I'm really happy. And I was just thinking about you and looking at you, and I'm not getting any questions to ask to you. All the answers, it's just a feedback. All the answers that you put forward to us is really helpful. And it is thank you, Chichi. Thank you so much.
Thank you, dear. We could meet directly if you are in
Kerala. Yes.
Yes.
Sweet, one question in the chat box. Any specific suggestion for aspirant who repeatedly failed in prelims? Please address it, no?
Sure. First, identify your mistakes. I think if you are repeatedly failing in the prelims, you are repeating the mistakes, definitely. If you are repeating the prelims, then the content part might not be the issue. you are having some knack or some skill for prelims is lacking within you. For that, a mentor can definitely help you. I might say that if you have some offline papers, that question papers that you have answered, you take their paper to the mentor. Vishnu sir itself can help you. Just scan it and send it to him. The way you answered the questions, the way you arrived at the questions, we could look into that and identify where you are lacking and work on that. Rather than just giving thousands of mock tests, do one test and identify the mistakes in that. Go to the mentor and ask him. It's our duty. And after all, it's our exam. It's our responsibility to go before the vendors. Go to them, ask them. They will always be ready to help you. Just ask them, what's the fault? Identify that fault and rectify it. Rectify it in the coming test and go for the examination. Definitely, you are going to clear this. That I'm pretty sure of that.
Very good answer. Does anyone want to ask any question more? Please raise the hand. Sister Harsha is asking that.
Do you make notes after reading the source PPT of anthropology? Actually, that itself was my base material. So rather than just consolidating or reducing that PPT to some notes, I literally go with that notes. And within that PDF, if I found some other anthropologist or some other textbook, I just noted in that PPT itself. In the side of that PPT, I just incorporated more. I didn't prepare a notes in separate because the time was very limited for me. So I prefer to have the smart work. Within the PPT, I noted the extra points.
The reason for choosing civil services.
That's what I said here much before, why I came to the civil services, because many times after being an agriculture engineer, I felt helpless. Even after knowing the issues, even after having solutions within my hand, I was not able to implement it. Power is important here. At some point, yes, we need the position, we need some platform. And now you all are listening to me because I have cleared this examination. Mm-hmm. Now I have a platform to introduce my ideas. So I consider this platform as this civil services as a platform where I could do my level best for the society. That is a motto.
Yashwant, do you have a question? Do you want to ask directly?
Hi, Chachi.
Hello.
It's pleasure meeting you today. And I also belong to your anthropology batch 2020 when Vishnu sir told me 3 days ago.
It's an online class, so we are not even aware of our classmates.
Yeah. So actually at that particular point of time, I've been still in college. Now, recently, 1 month ago, I've done with my graduation. So my question is how to be very motivated when all my friends are going to foreign, getting placed in MNCs. You know, I'm sitting in the home and going to HQ.
I also face the same issue. I can relate you. That's okay, dear. That's what I said. What made you to come here? What made you to attend the civil services is itself your motivation. Think of that. Why I didn't go for a campus placement? Why I didn't go abroad? Why I didn't look for my better half? That itself kept you motivated. If these kind of words or whatever I say now might last within you, might have an impact on you for some 2 or 3 days maximum. But your internal motivation will keep you go forward, and I'm pretty sure that you will come out with flying colors, and we are going to meet us.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, dear.
Suresh, Bhavik Suresh. Is unmuted, Bhavik Suresh.
First of all, congratulations again.
Thank you, Bhavik.
So, how in touch were you with your background subjects during your preparation? And did you have an interview question from your background in the sense college? So, how in touch were you during your preparation? Or you just did it in the interview stage, like when you knew that you're going to be called for the interview? And thank
actually,
you.
Actually, I didn't get your question. Are you asking my preparation during preparation?
This question is, agriculture engineering useful for your preparation? Any interview questions from agriculture background?
Definitely. I don't know who asked the question. It was
Bhavik.
Sir, Bhavik. Okay. Bhavik, For me, I'm really proud to say that even at this moment, I am an agriculture engineer. I will be an agriculture engineer for all the time because I really love my subject. I'm a really interested person in agriculture engineering. So, yes, definitely, that's something that brought me to the civil services. So, for my preparation phase, yes, that helped me motivated, that kept me motivated. For the interviews, yes, there were questions about agriculture. We had a very long conversation on agriculture, the agrarian crisis in India, how we can solve. As an engineer, what we can contribute. In that manner, yes, you can definitely expect questions from your graduation. You have to prepare thoroughly, not in the academic sense. I don't know what is the graduation of Bhavik, what is that?
Minus pharmacy, I did doctor pharmacy.
Pharmacy, okay. You can definitely get some questions from pharmacy, but you might not be asking about the chemical formula of some medicines. But that you can get the questions like, how is India's performance in that pharmacy sector? Yes, we are calling as the hub, but even then we are not able to get the IPR, proper intellectual property rights, or patents are very less. We are still focusing on generic medicine. What we can do as a person having background in pharmacy, getting your administration, what will be your priorities? Definitely you can get questions like that. You have to prepare. Ultimately, it's about like what they are going to ask.
Ma'am, during your preparation, were you keeping in touch with your background subjects, or you just waited till you passed mains and then you started?
No, I didn't look into. We have studied a number of theorems, number of derivations. I didn't look into that, but I always remain an agriculture engineer. So when I read a newspaper, when I saw something related to agriculture, I used to feel really excited. That's all.
So the last two questions. One question is from one of the students. Please provide your strategy for anthropology.
Strategy for anthropology. First thing is, I believed in Vishnu sir. I believed in him. Literally, we have to believe. That trust element is very important. When you interact with some person, you have to believe in him. When you have a roommate or the study partner, believe in him. That trust element is very important. That trust gives you the confidence. So I believe that yes, only questions from Vishnu sir's class will come. Only questions from Vishnu sir's class will come. Yes, there were some questions that was something that we didn't prepare. That's okay. That will happen because it is unpredictable service commission. But most of the questions I got from this classes itself, I believed in him. I worked on the PPTs. I studied the PPTs. I tried to add more. I literally read A to Z of the answer keys sir have provided. I compared it with my answers. I went through the suggestions he had given for the answers. And I worked on that. If sir write for my answer that there is no name of anthropologist in that. Yes, I know. It's my fault. Then I will take his answer key and look. When the answer key comes, you will feel astonished because it will be full of name of anthropologists. I was like, oh my God, these kind of anthropologists are there in our country. Then I will try to do my level best to study that and incorporate it in the next examination. And I will again look over what the command he is going to give me. Then sir says that, yeah, it's good answer. Then I think, oh my God, my work is worth. And for anthropology, do give some time daily for optional, because optional is very crucial. Give ample time. Work on the previous year questions. So I have tabulated it based on the syllabus itself. So it's very easy. When you look into the culture, you can get all the questions asked in culture. So go with that. Write maximum number of answers, the series. Don't skip that. Don't skip classes. Attend the classes. Don't feel that I can read all the PPTs and understand what is happening in that. Don't think like that. These explanations are very important. I know most of you, 99% won't have the graduation of the bachelor's degree in anthropology. So you are going to study it for the first time. Understand that what is anthropology? Anthropology is how we became what we are. So have that strategy for all the studies. Because if you are studying about marriage, and say what was it in the initial period? How it evolved? What is the position of marriage in the society at this point? What are the possible prospects in the future? In that manner, have a continuous analysis of everything. Because you are an anthropology student, whether it is a marriage, kinship, economic aspect, having that continuous cyclic analytical perspective. Anthropologists are very important. I know it's pretty painful to study and remember all their names, but you are supposed to do so, dears. So study the name of anthropologists, study their work. If possible, try to study the year of publication itself. That gives you an edge. Write maximum number of questions. For if it's biological anthropology, you are supposed to draw that diagrams. That's skull. Yes, it is painful, I know, but you are supposed to draw that skull of chimpanzee, gorilla, human, Australopithecus, Ardipithecus. Yes, you are supposed to try on that. Don't think that yes, I have good drawing skills. Yes, I understood these figures. I will draw it first itself in the examination hall. Don't think like that. It's very difficult at that point. Prepare beforehand itself. Go ahead, dears. Study well. It's your cup of tea.
The last question, and not question, it's best advice to the aspirants, which you
best want. Best advice, sir.
Yes.
Believe in yourself, dears. Believe in yourself. You are good enough. Then second thing is, accept the reality. Don't be too idealistic. Accept the reality. Identify your strengths. Identify your weaknesses. No one is perfect. Everyone will have the strengths, the weaknesses. Be ready to change. Not your basic. I might say we might follow the strategy of 2F. First, be firm on who you are. Be firm on your dignity. Don't be submissive before anyone. Be firm on why you came to this services. Second thing is be flexible in some aspect, because be ready to change. If your answers have some mistakes, be ready to change. Be open to criticism. Take the things in a positive manner. Look into the spirit rather than literally following something. Be who you are. Yes, you can clear it. Definitely, you can clear it.
Yes. Thank you, Sritu. One message. It started with ma'am and ended with Chichi. Thank you, ma'am, for your valuable answers. First of all, congrats, ma'am. Give us a broad idea about how to prepare for civil services as well as how to be motivated every day. Thank you, Sritu, Chichi. Glad to talk with you. Yes, everyone. We are very much happy.
Before ending this session, I have to say something. It's my privilege to have this session, because even the few days back, I was nothing. I was, even though I had a number of things to share with others, no one was there to hear. Because once you will clear this, there'll be a number of people there to hear you. It gives you a very great platform to do the things that you really wish in a positive manner. Be who you are. I'm really sure that if you are a serious aspirant, your hard work will definitely pay off. So believe in yourself. I wish all the very successful life in your life. I wish, rather than a successful life, I like to wish you a satisfied life. Because success is measured in the scale of someone else, but satisfaction is measured in the scale of yours itself. So I am pretty sure that you all will come out with flying colors, have a satisfied life ahead. Thank you, Vishnu sir. Thanks a lot for giving me an opportunity for interacting with the young minds, my future colleagues, the future bureaucrats of our country. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Welcome to Vishnu IAS Academy. We are excited to announce the launch of our new courses. Contact us for registrations and counseling. Hard work never fails. Keep learning.